He saved police in the last 2 years. In 2012, he scored the winning try. Last year, he kicked the winning penalty, but he's not here. And there's your go-to man in as far as the police kicking responsibilities is concerned, Api Salome Wangatambu. He did very well this year for Nandronga in as far as kicking is concerned, Bill.
Possession and territory is very, very important this game. Looking at the history of Sukuna Bowl, games have been won between the two teams by 1, 2, or 3 points difference. So the intensity of the games are very, very high. So at any chance, territory, possession, and points very, very important earlier on in the game.
Luita now outside to Mbosinawai. I mean, on the inside is Ovini Mgurekalo. Now police mount the early attack, but early blemish for the police side. Maybe the early nerves. They need to shake it off. Amani Mbosinawai knocked it through, but they look promising on that occasion. Unfortunately, it was lost forward by Amani Mbosinawai. And this will be the first scrum of the 2014 ANZ Sukuna Bowl. They look promising on that occasion, police. But Amani Mbosinawai lost it forward. And it will be the Nandi man, former Suva Grammar School student, Nemani Koroitamana. Two Nemanis in the number 9 and number 10 jerseys for the Army side. So it's a Nemani combination for Army. Nemani Koroitamana at halfback, and at first 5-8 is Nemani Ndriu. Mbolambi is not happy with the scrum, so
Crouch!
Laying down the laws earlier on in the game.
Set.
He's a very strict referee as well, James. There you have it. First penalty to Ami inside their own half. So we've seen in the first 3 minutes of this match, two penalties, one to Ami and one to police. So both teams are sizing up each other earlier on. Tiki Ladiv Wimbau, this is the man. I think that police will have to watch out for this afternoon. Tiki Ladiv Wimbau at fullback for Army, the former under 20 rep, former national under 20 rep, the Teilebu Northland of fullback. Oh, yesterday I saw him kick a 58 meters he converted a penalty shot while they were having their captain's run 58 meters out. Now Army,
scrappy ball from the Army side, trying to target that that middle channel, but didn't execute that quite well.
Sireli Kalodava bundle into touch, and there's the early challenge. Kalodava and also Vesira Rarawa, as well as Manu Langai, who was taken into touch by Vesira Rarawa. James Bolomir is up for a time off. He just asked Vesira Rarawa to come down. Out it comes, but Army have made a mess of that one. But they've managed to regroup. No, it's been turned over by police. Now it comes on the short side, but Dr. Luita loses the ball in the process. Early nerves, as I said.
Early nerves from both sides, just trying to set up that execution from set plays. Very, very important that both teams attempt to do first things first on the set plays, from catching and passing the ball to the very little things. And I guess the team that plays that well today will come out winners at the end of the 80 minutes.
That's right. Police first won the Sukuna Bowl when it started in 1951. Army first won in 1952. Great scrummaging as well from the police side. Nemanin Ryu decides go in the air, but they don't want to give it to that man. With space, Higgy will haunt you. Ami have turned it over. Koroitamana, Aisake Katunimbao. Again, another knock forward by this time it's Ami. Mitsina Vangilevu thought he's away.
Ami really working well in the tackle area. There's counter racking on Wangatambu's counter attacking ball. It's very good on the arriving Ami players.
But one thing I've noticed as well is Ami scrum, they need to fix their scrum earlier on, because the first two scrums they struggled, Ami. So they need to tighten those the so-called nuts and bolts in their scrums in order to contain this formidable police forward pack.
Well, we are seeing that second scrum of the game, that will be an area that police will try and infiltrate within the Army set pieces.
The Army fans are still waiting. Maybe if this a shot from Tikiladi Vuimbau goes over, we can see them jumping on the grandstand. Tikiladi Vuimbau. He's a very prolific goal kicker. As I said yesterday, he nailed a 58-meter kick during the captain's run.
Strikes it well.
Vuimbau have converted and also registered the first points this afternoon. The 2014 ANZ Sukuna Bowl Challenge. Tikiladi Vuimbau, the former national under-20 ref, have registered the first points for the Army side. And the police, they don't need, they can't afford to make a lot of mistakes and give away silly penalties, because Vuimbau is a very capable goal kicker, Bill.
Well, that is an asset that the Army team will tend to use in the course of the game. Every opportunity to kick a goal. And early points, as I said, will be very, very important with the territory that Vuimbau can gain from his huge kicks.
And again, he booted that one out, but unfortunately it didn't go out. Now Lawapo from inside his own 22. Navangilevu outside his 22. Now Navar. It's back in field and breaks the first tackle. Ami needs to set this one up, and they've lost that through as well.
There's a lot of 50-50 passes being thrown.
That's right, Bill. Ami and both sides can't afford to do that. Katunimbao. Lautoka prop forward Kalibati Tawake. Now Ami from inside their own half, they managed to go over the police half. Neman Indriu tries to burrow his way through, but no way through there. Tambakana Langi. The skipper Katunimbao. And now Modetandra. Mbure Kalou made sure that Modetandra will not go anywhere. And breaking through is Kalibati Tawake. Wangambada Kotombalavu in support. Out it comes. They've got numbers, Ami. They've got numbers. Modetandra on the far side, but lost the ball forward. And the Army side throwing the ball around. Play, yes, that's right, Bill. They're throwing the ball around, and they've made their intentions clear earlier on that they'll run at this police side. They will not keep it close. They will spread the ball wide, Bill.
Yes, they've shown that in a few passages of play. But I think that there's been a lot of infringements from the police side. There's been a couple of late tackles and offsides from that passage of face play from the police side. And the police should be very wary of Tikiladi's boots.
the Blues flags there on the grandstand.
So it was just an attacker, so I can just talk to the player.
And now we'll cross over to the sideline commentator, Asinate Weningol.
Well, it's already a furious start here in the first few minutes of this game in the Sukuna Bowl Challenge. And we saw the early aggression. But, you know, as far as points is concerned, it's the Army team that are on the board, 3 points to nil. They've weathered it nicely, and they're ahead at the moment.
That's right. Thanks, Asinate. Now, Apsalomi Wangatambu from inside his own 22. Oh, knocked through by Mitieli Navangilevu.
That's a rare mistake from Miti.
That's right. It's unlike Navangilevu. Army applying the pressure, and this is a very good platform for them to attack from. And Navangilevu dropped that ball just 7 meters out from his own try line. So it will be a scrum feed. So Army now have options to the left and to the right. Bill.
That's a very interesting position for their scrum. Stacking four of the attackers to the right side of the field, with Tikiladi standing directly behind the scrum, putting the police defensive line on the guess on which side the Army attack would go. Set.
Nemani Koroitamana. As I said, the Army needs to fix their scrum, and it cost them on that occasion. That's the third scrum that Army have struggled with earlier on, but Mitieli Navangilevu throws a wild pass again. It's been picked up by the Army side. They have to clean it up. Now it comes Paulo Andrani Sekula. Navar cut shot in his tracks by Manu Langai. Another penalty now to Army, quickly taken by Isaac Katunimbau, the skipper, leading by example, Kalivati Tawake. Just 3 meters out. Nemani Koritamana Savitambanalangi. Again, Katunimbau. That's his trademark offload. Nava, Tambanalangi again. Kalivati Tawake. Now they go wide. And a cross kick by Nemani Ndiu. Michaeli Modetandra on the far side. But calling for a mark and cool under pressure is Api Salome Wangatambu. So police escapes yet again.
There was yet another good attacking opportunity for Ami, failing to capitalize and turn into points. Kicking away possession in the inside the 22 is something that the Ami wouldn't want to be doing with this close, tight competitive games. Aquila.
That's right, Bill. Well, Api Salome Wangatambu experience that showed there, and the Gold Coast Sevens top try scorer, Api Salome Wangatambu. The interesting fact about Wangatambu at the Gold Coast Sevens was he came off the bench, but he was the top try scorer. Another scrappy line out from from police. Police now working hard to regain possession. Amani Mbosinawai. But Tikiladi Vuimbau fielding well for Ami and decides to go for a high ball. But again, losing it forward is the police side. And it will be another scrum. So Army applying the early pressure, but the only thing that Army needs to work on now is their scrum, because they've been applying the pressure early on in the first 15 minutes of this match. They've been applying the pressure, but their scrum is what they need to really work on, Bill.
A couple of lineouts that Army has not won cleanly. I guess this is where the police will certainly continue to insert a lot of pressure.
Well, Bill, that you can't win any game if you struggle in your set pieces. So Army and also police, they both need to clean that out, because Otherwise, they will struggle throughout this match.
They both teams have good ball carriers with ball in hand. But I guess with those ball carriers, you need to have good go-forward platforms from the set plays. And if Army continue to lose out on their scrum, they will really be on the back foot most of the times, and that will be a lot difficult for them to attack from.
The Army bench waiting for their turn to get some action this afternoon. And also time for a water break for the players, but it's a scrum feed to Army and Nemani Koritamana. Just 12 meters out from police try line. Army leading police 23 points. 23 points, rather 3 points to nil. Army leading 3 points to nil.
Looking at the start of the game, Quila, there's a lot of enthusiasm shown from both teams. Both teams wanting to have that offload from the contact area. But it's been a bit scrappy from the start, with a lot of drop balls and a lot of indecisiveness. And I guess that's some things that the coaches will be stressing out at halftime or during the breaks, just to get that ball security and control on the balls while on attack.
That's right, but Manulangai breaking away now, supported by Nambahiki. Now the police side, it's their chance to attack. It's their turn to attack, but Tonendelana lost it forward, but it was a very nice break by the police side. But Tonendelana, the super lock forward, unfortunately, he lost it forward. And the police bench, they thought Langai, they've run away for a try. At 14 and a half minutes gone, it's still Army 3 and police nil. That's the break from Manu Langai. Number, and it was a Tonendelana. But Tikila Divuimbau came in with a good tackle, and that's where.
There's a very good hit from Tikila Divuimbau. Looking at that last passage of play, this is how police would definitely want the game to go. A lot of loose plays with scrambling defense and making use of their highly skilled players running up the channels, waiting for that offloaded ball.
That's what both teams have done so far in as far as this game is concerned. The offloads, the 50-50 passes, they're trying to grab every opportunity, but it can't haunt them if they overdo it, because both sides have, as you said, Bill, great ball carriers and all the great game breakers as well. Like for police, we got Nathangi Levu, we have Wanga Tambu there as well, and Tunaisa Turanga View. But for Army, there's Michael Modetandra Isake Katunimbao. Scrum feed to Army right on the 10 meter line.
Set. Stay.
Wangambada Kotumbalavu at the back. Koroitamana. Tikila Divuimbau. Michael Modetandra. But he's well looked after on the far side by Api Salome Wangatambu and Miti Nathangi Levu.
Army manages to hold that scrum very well.
That's right. They can give space as well to that guy, Mitieli Nathangilebu, and the Army fans waiting for something to cheer about this afternoon. Going for a drop goal with Army. The referee says play on. Tikila Divuimbau taking his chances. Amani Mbosinawai, it's going to be a 22-meter restart. Apisalome Wangatambu handled the kicking responsibilities, but now we'll cross over to Asinate from the sideline.
Yeah, just talking about Absalom Ewangatambu, he's been a real key player for Police this afternoon. He's been really safe under the high ball. He's been getting a lot of action, but it's also nice to see the fullback from Ami Tikiladi Vuimba also playing well this afternoon. Great conditions here at the ANZ Stadium. Not too hot, just a nice cloud cover, but you know, action already underway. Ami in the lead, 3-0.
Thanks. Thank you, Asinate and Bill. As we said earlier, the conditions, great conditions here at the ANZ Stadium. No excuses, but still we see a lot of drop balls early on.
Yes, there's been a lot of drop balls, a lot of stoppages, a lot of scrums. This is what both teams wouldn't want to be stuck in. The fans too have come out here today to watch an entertaining and exciting game of rugby with the ball being moved around.
20 minutes left in this first half. Still Ami leading by 3-0. Mbosinawai, Turanga Viu, out it comes, Mitele Navangilevu. And Wangatambu again losing the ball forward. Playing advantage is referee Mbolambiu. I thought Navangilevu was away on that occasion, but looking after him well was the Ami's keeper, Isake Katunimbau. He's Gold Coast Sevens teammate, Ais Katunimbau. There we have it, Tunaisa Turangaviu, and I thought that Navangilevu will outrun Maikeli Mwadetandra, but...
Just the execution, Kwila, on those plays. Was a perfect pass.
Set, hold!
Nemani Korotamana again. Ami struggling with the scrum. They've lost their own throw. It's been picked up by Jock Luita on the short side. Ulea Silawabo. Again, a 50-50 pass, but that's been reclaimed by the Ami side inside their own half. Tikiladi Vuimbao outside his own 22. Again, a drop ball by Miti Navangilevu. Not a great day in the office for Mitieli Navangilevu. Not only Navangilevu, but Wangatambu, and as well as Tony Ndelana. Police, they need to regroup, because we have got 21 minutes gone in the first half, and they still struggling, Bill.
Yes. Still hasn't got the momentum that people have expected this game to take its charge. There's still a lot of enthusiasm and excitement on the field from the players. A lot of players trying to push the attack and forcing those passes and causing the game stop start nature.
17 and a half minutes left in this first half. Ami 3, and again another lost scrum by the Ami side, lost through by Ulias Lobo. Now it's Ami knocked backwards. Is the referee Sitiveni Kunanga outside his own 10 meter line? Katunimbau at halfback. Scrappy play from both sides, and this is not what the fans expected, and also our viewers on the Sky Pacific, and also around the globe through the live stream. Welcome to the ANZ Stadium. Thanks for joining us. And if you have just joined us, Ami is leading Police by 3-0 with 17 minutes left in the first half. It was Tikiladi Vuimbau who nailed a penalty in the 8th minute of play. But it's ever since then, it's been scrappy play from both sides. Vuimbau decides to put it high. And again, knocked through, but now it's been picked up by it's Marakiwai. And he's going to go over and score the first try. Believe him, Marakiwai of Ami goes over. It all came from that high ball from Tikiladi Vuimbau. And it was the BB Police side. The golden rule about high balls, you don't let it bounce. And they let the ball bounce on that occasion. And it bounced kindly into the hands of Marakiwai. And look at the Ami fans this afternoon. They've got something to cheer about. And also, they've extended their lead. Here is how the try was scored. Tikiladi Vuimbau.
Aquila, it wasn't only about the high ball. It was about the time the ball hung up in the air that allowed the army chasers to catch on to where the ball was going to land, that helped army score the try. So indeed, Tikilavi Wimbao's boots an asset for the army side in that passage of play leading up to the try.
That's right, it was Tikiko Uluiviti who knocked it forward, and the bounce of the rugby ball, sometimes it will be kind and sometimes not too kind, but on their case it was kind enough for the army side. Vilive Marakewai diving over for the army's first try this afternoon, as Tikiladi Wimbao tries to add the extras, but away to the right and upright, and it's gonna, the scores remain army leading now by 8 points to nil with 14 and a half minutes left in the first half. Bill,
well, let's hope both sides will get some consistency in place, both from set play and face play, after that break from the try, and just the continuity from play after play is what both sides will be working on from these passages of play.
Mbosinawai, but that's a penalty, taking the play in the air. Was it obstruction? A penalty to Police, quickly taken by Danling Airi. Danling Airi, this is his seventh straight Sukuna Bowl match. Again, knocked through by Police, and now they'd be, the referee was playing advantage all along. This may be an easy three-pointer for Police with the capabilities of Amani Mbosinawai, but they've decided to go for a try. Out it comes again, Mbosinawai, Atuturanga view. Bounces off Nemani Ndriu, but great leg drive as well from the former Vodafone Fiji Mbati rep. And also Northland, second 5-8. Pick and drive for Police. They are just inches out from the try line. Police, Setefano Somoza dives over. But it's been held up. Held up, says the referee.
Police side trying to cross that white line at all costs, not wanting to take the three-pointer.
That's right, and Setefano Somoza says, can you liaise with the in-goal Tazaz Batsa? James Mbolambiu told him, no, I saw it clearly. It was on the foot of an army player, so it was properly grounded. So it's still army leading by 8 points to nil, but Police have the advantage now. 5 meter scrum. Will that quick tap haunt them later? I thought they should have gone for the 3 points, well, but it was the skipper's call, Bill.
That's how confident they are of crossing the line, Kwila.
Another scrum, says Mbolambiu.
Well, you can see that Police is dominating the scrums. We'll
That's
see
right.
whether they will take that to the advantage in this passage of play.
That's right. This is where they will need it the most. They are just 5 meters out. And the scrum has been twisted by the army side. It's a penalty. Someone has taken it quickly. Ulea Silawapo inches out. Pick and drive by Police. But great defensive play by the army side. Isaac Katunbao urging his players to keep defending. Someone shouted there, sir, I have scored. It was Danley Neyri, but it will be another 5 meter scrum, this time again to the in favor of the Police side. It will be a scrum feed to Police. The Police fans waiting for something to cheer about this afternoon at the ANZ stadium, and army at the moment leading by 8 points to nil. Wouldn't these fans love a try from Police? That would certainly cheer them up this afternoon.
Well, Danling Airi's 7 years of experience in Sukuna Bowl would be for nothing. You'll only have people with that much experience asking the referee whether it's a try or not.
Jock Luita has been controlled well at the back, but the army forwards holding on. It's at the back there with Uleyasi Lawabo. And now Police regroup. Police side regroup. There's Zint is out, but great counter-racking as well by police. By Army, rather, Jock Luita. And going alone is Etonia Namba. Another penalty, another penalty. Will this be a yellow card?
Number two.
He's calling on number two.
No ice.
Manasa Tunraki.
Stay there. Not releasing the tackle player intentionally. What's up? It's a yellow card. What's up?
The referee telling him not releasing the player in the tackle, but Manasa Tuinraki told Mwalambiu, what's up to say? I'm sorry, but James Mwalambiu told him, I'll give you a yellow card, I'm sorry as well. And Manasa Tuinraki will spend the next 10 minutes in the bin. So this means that Army will be without their hooker. That means a loose forward will go out, and one of the front rows on the bench will have to come in. And now the maybe referee informing the skipper Isake Katunimbau that one of the loose men has to go out. And the army, one of the front rows will have to come in. I think it's Asirim Buli.
Now last crap. Kim do wanna send building to Kim do sa Kim do X2. Then a polls are out. Don't go next time.
Oh, okay.
And the great refereeing by James Mbolambiu informing them of his decision why Tuinraki was sent off. And the players acknowledged the referee's decision, but they're still waiting for. And now we have it there. It's Manasa Tuinraki. No, rather, it's Asirim Buli. We have coming now for Manasa Tuinraki. Another penalty. This is the fourth successive penalty. Now it comes forward. Jock Luita. Has he scored a try? No, it's still a penalty. So, three occasions, police have gone over the try line, but great defensive play by Army Bill.
Yes, very good defensive play from Army, especially just 5 meters away from the try line. And that is 15 points for police.
Manu Langai, Luita. Out it comes, Amani Mbosinawai dummies his way through, but it's been turned over by Nemani Koroitamana. And as I said earlier, they should have taken the 3 points, police. Go back into their territory with points. But now they've lost their opportunity. Tikiladi Vuimbao. He will not put it out of play. And again, it's been knocked through, but it's been picked up by Army. Army has picked it up. Maikeli Modetandra. I thought Maikeli Modetandra will go all the way. But he looks heavy to me on that occasion, Maikeli Modetandra.
Well, it's just good cover defense from Mitieli Ringlebu, and he's not slow too, Mitieli.
Whether Maikeli Modetandra have lost some pace that he's renowned for, or it's just Mitieli Ringlebu is faster than him. But on his day, Maikeli Modetandra, no one could have caught up to him. But look at how my Mitieli Ringlebu tapped the ball off his hand. His former Nandronga teammate. And look at that, he's disappointed, but his keeper Isake Katunimbau encouraging him that he has done his best. A near try again for the Army side. But this time Army twisting the scrum, and I think that's the sixth penalty. Sixth scrum penalty to police, or against Army. Choeli Vitayaki not happy with Kalifati Tawaki. And the Army fans, they are leading by, Army leading by 8 points to nil. Again, I thought Maikeli Modetandra will go in and score Army's second try, but it was Miti Nathangilevu who caught up to him.
That was a wasted situation, but a very desperate defensive attempt from Miti Nathangilevu that saved another Ami possible try.
Manu Langai, but knocked through now by Jokluita, picked up again by Ami. There, but knock on both ways, so the referee will take the first knock on, and that was from police Jokluita. He didn't expect that. And we're just a few minutes away from the end of the first half, and it looks like police is still trying to settle down.
Yes, they're still trying to get the rhythm for their attack, even though they're dominating the set pieces, especially the scrum.
Right, they're dominating the set pieces, but on the scoreboard they are behind by 8-0. Now it's been picked up by the back by Wangambata Kotobalavu, Marakiwai Bilibe, but the ball was lost forward. Was it lost forward? Now we're going to take the line out. Nemani Koroitamana calling the shots. Danling Airi, the former Flying Fijians hooker, also former Flying Fijians prop forward. His seventh successive Sukuna Bowl clash. So that's 7 years in a row. The Army fans and Vesira Rawa asking James Mbolombi why they were penalized in the last scrum. And another scrum feed, and this time Army will try to improve on it before the end of the first half. We are just minutes away from the end of the first half. Army still leading by 8-0. Jokluita right on his 22 meter line. Algam Zamani Mbosinawai atu Turangai View to meet in Adangilevu. Wangatabu tries to outrun Michaeli Modetandra, but Modetandra equal to the challenge on that occasion of Inimbure Kalo. Look at the Army swarming defense. Nambahiki manages to break out of the first two tacklers. Again, Jokluita. Tamis his way through and break through Jokluita. He needs support. Knocks it through. Army regroup now. Wangamata Kotumbalabu just outside his own half. Play on, says Mbolambiu. Kalivati Tawake. Manu Langai knocked it through. Was it deliberate? No, it wasn't. Remember, Army playing with police playing with 15 men, while Army playing with 14. Manasa Twindraki is in the sin bin, so police need to capitalize on that and make use of the extra men that they've got. Bill.
Yes, still a lot of execution problems that we've seen in the game. A lot of drop balls, a lot of forced passes, a lot of 50-50 passes, and the game hasn't gotten its rhythm that we had expected from the beginning of the match. Reaching the break. Hopefully the coaches will re-emphasize these important points during the halftime break.
That's right, as we have as we wait for the matchup to resume, we'll cross over to on the sideline with Asinate.
Well, Asiri Mbuli, as far as the Army team is concerned, is still in the naughty corner, so Army still 14 men only on the field, but they've managed to handle police well. They've kept them contained, and I guess as far as the brains trust is concerned, Esala Naunga, a good tactic from him using the high ball, and that has resulted in a try for them this afternoon. They're using that tactic well, and of course he'll know the back three well for the police team, particularly with the fullback and the two wingers, Wangatambu as well as Mipieli Nadangilevu. He knows them well, and he's testing them out with the high ball, and so far it's worked to Army's advantage.
Thanks, Zasinate, and it's Chone Saukuru wearing the number 23 jersey for Army, going in now to replace former Flying Fijian speedster Maikeli Modetanra. So Modetanra is injured, and he will be out for the rest of this challenge. And Chone Saukuru, the super winger, will replace him this afternoon. Chone Saukuru is a very prolific finisher as well, wearing the number 23 jersey for Army this afternoon.
Reading Asinate's comments just a while back, you know, the Army side are fully utilizing Tikilavi's boots. The hang time on Tikilavi's high balls are quite phenomenal, and it's something that the outside backs are chasing on to really well, causing a lot of pressure on both the police wingers. But if you have noticed, Quila, for the past passage of the few minutes of play, all Tikilavi's bombs and high kicks have been going on to the left corner of the stadium, putting a lot of pressure on Tikiko Uluibiti, who plays center most of the time, and very little time on the wing.
That's right. That's the area they are targeting this afternoon, Tikiko Uluiviti's corner, and Maikeli Modetanra. Well, unfortunately, that's it for him for the 2014 ANZ Sukuna Bowl challenge. And Maikeli Modetanra will have an early shower this afternoon, but now we'll get back to the main action as Nemani Koroitamana now ready to fit into the scrum for the Army side. Army, they've got numbers to the left and to the right. Remember, they are one man short. So I think the best option for the Army side is give it to Tikilavi Vuimbau, who can then put it downfield. That's the only way to go. They can't afford to play in their own territory because they are one man short, as Manasa Twinraki is spending time on the beam.
Tikilavi has been standing quite deep, right behind the scrum, getting ready for that kick. And the police defense has caught on to him at that point in time.
And Isake Katunimbao, the skipper, caught in possession. But it was great work by Atunaisa Turangai View and also Manu Langai. But now, Tikilavi Vuimbao inside his own try line, but not a good clearing kick. Apisalome Wangatambu chips it through, and now Wangatambu, will he go over and score? But his chip kick beats him on that occasion. He got the pace, but the chip kick was more than what he expected.
That was another desperate attempt to cross over the line from Wangatambu, Quila.
That's right. But in reality, he beat the Army defenders, but the ball just beats him out of play. And on that occasion, another near try by the police side. Now Wangatambu again. Tikiko Uluiviti, we have not seen much of him. Manueli Langai. Langai breaks away from one tackle, but it's been lost forward by Nemari Koroitamana. Quickly pouncing on it is the skipper, Setefano Somoda, but the referee says play on. Ovini Mburekalo, out it comes. They've got numbers, police, but it's been kicked through by Isake Katunimbao. Still there for the Army side. They've turned it over. Tone Sokuru. Scrappy play from both sides. Aminia Sinova. Another chance now for Army, for police rather. Jock Luita. Ovini Mburekalo. Caught in a tackle by Aseri Mbuli. Playing it up back is the skipper, doubling around, taking two Army defenders with him. Stay there. Army needs to score in this first half. And meeting Nathangilebu, an inside pass. But Nafa, just like a classic loose forward, pouncing on the loose balls. Tone Saukuru. But Wangatambu, they can't give him space. They can't afford to do that. Wangatambu. And it's been lost forward by Wangatambu. It threw by Katurimbao. But it's been picked up again by Mitili Nathangilebu. Scrappy play from both sides as we're nearing the halfway mark. And also we're nearing halftime as well. Dabbing his way through. Is Mbosinawai. In support is Mitili Nathangilebu. Was that a high shot? Yes, the referee has shot. His hand out now. Dan Lingairi. Oh, great piece of play, Dan Lingairi. But Nambahiki now gives it back in field. Mitili Nathangilebu. Remember, they've got an extra man out wide. Another penalty. Unforced errors, Bill.
Well, it's sort of improved a bit, Aquila, but just needs a lot more consistency. We've seen that the last the play we had five phases. I think that's the longest time we have had the ball in hand from either of the teams.
And this was great piece of play by Darling Airy. Back pass picked up by Nambahiki. On to a speeding Nathangilebu.
That's a pure Tua special from Darling Airy, Kula.
That's right, but the Nathangilebu, he shot through, but he was taken in a good tackle by Tikiladi Vuimbao. But this time, good sense has prevailed, and Somoda have opted for Apisalome Wangatambu to take a shot at goal as the first half, as we're about to finish this first half. Just a few minutes left now in this first half. Wangatambu, that looks good, and that's the first points, and that's it as well for the first 40 minutes in the first half. Police trailing the Army side, the defending champions Police trailing Army by 3 points to 8, Bill.
Yes, a lot of inconsistencies in the first half, but let's hope when both teams come back from the break that there'll be a lot of improvement in terms of consistency and continuity of play, as the fans have come to watch this afternoon. A lot of inconsistencies in set pieces. And
I will cross over to Asinate with this Army skipper.
I have with me a winning captain at the moment in the first half, Isaki Katrimbao. You've played and you've defended like men possessed.
Is this the game? First half was quite physical, I guess come the second half, we're looking forward to move the ball a bit, not to encounter those physical confrontation, just to move the ball around and just to play smart, look for possession, and maintain that possession and score some tries.
Thank you very much, Katrimba. All the best.
Thank you. Cheers.
That's right, Isaki Katunimbao, that's the plan for the second half. They have to move the ball wide. They did that well on a couple of occasions in the first half. But we will be back for the next 40 minutes. And again, the million-dollar question is, will Police retain this ANZ Sukuna Bowl this afternoon? Or will the Army side take it to Delai Nambua?
This program is brought to you in partnership with Niranjans.
Stay safe. A community message from the National Fire Authority.
The challenge was to make the truck into a globally competitive product. Their competitive success and expertise has been used to build uncompromised toughness in each truck that rolls off the line. Taken to the next level through a full model change, the new Hino 300 series is born.
Now we'll check out some highlights from the first 40 minutes. Even though there was some scrappy play, but still there were some promising passages of play as well. Army nearly scoring earlier on, but it was Pisalomi Wangatambu, very cool under pressure. The first try to the Army side, that was Vilive Marakiwai after Tikikwe Uliviti lost the ball forward from a Tikiladi Wimbau high ball, and it was Vilive Marakiwai bouncing on the loose ball. And this is another one, I thought for all money Michael Modetanra will go all the way, but I think he thought that no one is after him, and Miti Nathangilevu who knocked off his hand, and it was also a very promising passage of play from police as well. Nathangilevu after some earlier blemish in the first few minutes of the first half, and that Biotuai backup pass by Dan Lingeri was one of the highlights of the first half. And Dan Lingeri playing in his seventh Sukuna Bowl clash in a row. And the fans are still waiting for both teams to come back into the field of play for the start of the second 40 minutes. At the moment, it's 8-3 in favor of Army after the first 40 minutes. A try by Vilive Marakiwai and also a penalty to Tikiladi Wimbau. But on the stroke of full time in the first half, in the first 40 minutes, it was Apisalome Wangatambu who converted a penalty to police to give them their 3 points in the first half.
This program is brought to you in partnership with Niranjits.
Hey kids, remember what mom and dad always said about playing with matches, lighters, mosquito coils and candles?
Put it away, it's not a toy. Put it away.
Hey, listen up now.
Put it away, it's not a toy. Put it away,
don't play with that.
Put it away, it's not a toy. Put it away,
all together now.
Put it away, it's not a toy. Put it away, it's not a toy.
The challenge was to make the truck into a globally competitive product. Their competitive success and expertise has been used to build uncompromised toughness in each truck that rolls off the line. Taken to the next level through a full model change, the new Hino 300 series is born.
Now we'll be hoping to see a lot more consistency and continuity with both face play and set play. Police would most probably come back firing and using their prowess in the scrums to try and dominate second half set pieces. And also in the lineouts, Army has been inconsistent. Not many good go forward balls, but tries have resulted from the utilizing of Tikiladi's high kicks, and that is something that surely the Army team will try and reuse in this second half of the game.
And off we go for the second 40 minutes of this 2014 ANZ Sukuna Bowl clash. Kalivati Tawake from outside his own 22 meter line. Now Tikiladi Vuimbao inside his own 22. But Jock Luita miscalculates that one. Now it's Uleya Silawabo. He's not having a very promising afternoon, Uleya Silawabo. That's his third knock-on this afternoon, Ulai. And also, interestingly, the Army side have come on to the second half with a new set of gist. It's going to be a police scrum feed. And Army playing with the full 15 players now, as Manasa Twindraki is back in the field of play. So Nemani Koroitamana. Mbolambiu not happy. One minute gone in the second half. Police 3, Army 8. Now this is interesting, whether Army have managed to improve on the scrum, and after the first half prep talk, whether they can improve on this. And I don't think so. So that's
same infringements happening all over again. Has to do with the bind.
That's like
having a short arm bind from the Army prop.
That's right, Kalivati Tawake. That's like the seventh scrum penalty against Army this afternoon. So they really need to work on. On the bench, we have Mbanu Vendreti Verrata, Sireli Lendua, and Asi Rimbuli. And you look front row. Now Dan Lingairi.
Now the second half will be very, very important for both sides. Looking into the timing of the substitutions and the right substitutions being made at the right time for both teams will be something that the coaches, both coaches, will be working on for the second half.
Aminia Sinava stole that one. He's been working tirelessly this afternoon. Manasa Twindraki. Will it be out on the full? Oh, great piece of play. That's great understanding by Apisalome Wangatambu. That means the ball is out on the full. And again, experience showing there. He just put one foot on the field and one out on the touchline. And that's where they got the decision from. So police mount the early attack in the second half. Chonindelana, Mbosinawai. Standing start for Sireli Kaludava. Jog Luita. Delana again, now Denlingairi. The skipper got a few meters, but it's been turned over by Ami Wangambada. Koroitamana. Now it's Savenada Tambakanalangi. Have police turned it over. Yes, it's a penalty to police. Penalty to police. Apisalome Wangatambu, it's within his range. They can take the shot at goal, and yes, they will do that. So Apisalome Wangatambu will step up once again to try and add the extras and make it a 2 points ball game, Bill. Apisalome Wangatambu lining up to take this shot at goal. But it's not a good looking shot. It will fall short as well. Tikiladi Wimbawo has been hammered in his own try line by Mitieli Nadangilebu. So it will be a 5 meter scrum in favor of army or police rather.
Police so that's applying early pressure from that penalty kick.
That's right.
And they would want to keep army inside the 22 for the second half.
Tikiladi Wimbao, he was nailed on his own in his own try line by Tikiko Uluiviti.
Now there's a lot of pressure being mounted on Tikiladi, taking a few steps in trying to launch his kicks, but police have come very, very quickly, both on his inside and outside shoulder.